Bonjour tout le monde. Good afternoon. Welcome to the fifth daily press conference of this week with me. I'm joined here today by Minister Joly and virtually by Deputy Prime Minister Freeland and Ministers Anand, Fraser, Sajjan to announce further measures in response to the tragedy in Ukraine. The world is witnessing the horrors of President Putin's war of choice. This is a brutal, needless attack on a sovereign, democratic country. It is an atrocity for Ukraine's over 40 million innocent citizens and for the world. Le mépris du président Poutine pour la liberté, la démocratie, le droit international et la vie humaine doit avoir des conséquences. Plus tôt aujourd'hui, j'ai eu une rencontre avec nos alliés de l'OTAN. J'ai aussi eu un appel avec le premier ministre britannique Boris Johnson pour parler de nos actions concertées en réponse à la situation qui se détériore rapidement. Comme on l'a fait clairement savoir, le Canada, avec ses alliés et ses partenaires, est prêt à intensifier sa réponse et à imposer des conséquences encore plus lourdes au président Poutine et à ceux qui l'aident. Today, Canada is announcing our third set of severe, coordinated sanctions. First, we will be imposing sanctions on President Putin and his fellow architects of this barbaric war, his chief of staff and foreign minister, Sergei Lavrov. These men bear the greatest responsibility for the death and destruction occurring in Ukraine. Additionally, I am confirming Canada's support to remove Russia from the SWIFT payment system, a critical part of the global banking system. We've made it clear that all options are on the table when it comes to imposing steep costs on Russia's unjustified and unprovoked invasion, and that includes taking steps to exclude Russia from making financial transactions around the world. Excluding Russian banks from SWIFT would make it even more difficult for President Putin to finance his brutalities. Canada is also announcing that we will levy additional sanctions on Belarus and its leaders for abetting President Putin's invasion of a free and sovereign nation. These will target 57 individuals and are in addition to the dozens of existing strong sanctions already leveled against Alexander Lukashenko's regime for their repeated systematic human rights violations and decades of oppression of their own people. Aujourd'hui, le Canada annonce une troisième série de sanctions concertées. Ces sanctions visent le président Poutine, son chef de cabinet, ainsi que son ministre des Affaires étrangères, Sergei Lavrov. Elles visent aussi le régime du Bélarus qui a facilité cette invasion. De plus, on annonce également que le Canada appuie fortement le retrait de la Russie du réseau bancaire SWIFT. Le coût humain de cette crise est énorme. Le monde est témoin des scènes tragiques de bombardements et de déplacements massifs. Le président Poutine provoque une crise de réfugiés en Europe. Je sais qu'il est dans la nature des Canadiens de vouloir aider. Les Canadiens sont toujours prêts à faire leur part et à être généreux pour les gens les plus vulnérables. Alors aujourd'hui, on annonce que notre gouvernement va donner une somme équivalente pour chaque dollar donné à la Croix-Rouge canadienne en réponse à la crise humanitaire en Ukraine, jusqu'à concurrence de 10 millions de dollars. Today, we are announcing that our government will match every donation you make to the Canadian Red Cross Ukraine Humanitarian Crisis Appeal up to $10 million. This money will go directly to supporting relief efforts in the region. This is in addition to the $50 million for development humanitarian aid previously announced and the $620 million in sovereign loans we have made available to Ukraine's government. On a more personal note, let me just say that I've had the pleasure of getting to know Vladimir Zelensky, the president of Ukraine, quite well over the past number of years. Like I told him when we spoke yesterday, I am inspired by his resolve and his devotion to his country. He is the embodiment of the courage of Ukrainian people. And just like him, Ukrainian people are showing incredible strength and resilience. President Putin's war on Ukraine is a war on freedom, on democracy, and on the rights of Ukrainians and all people to determine their own future. President Putin has opened the darkest chapter yet in his assault on the Ukrainian people, but he has made a grave miscalculation. People around the world, including in the streets of Moscow and St. Petersburg, are standing against his brutal and unnecessary war. They are standing with Ukraine, as are all of us. Canada, and increasingly the world, stand united and unwavering in our support of Ukraine. Merci.